There we go.
What the fuck is the on switch?
Melissa's playing Fallout.
And dying of radiation poisoning.
People on the internet were telling me I have to do upstrokes and downstrokes, but the upstroke makes a different noise than just the downstroke.
Yeah.
Like if you're playing really fast, like then it makes sense. But if you're just going like, and then you do that with upstroke and downstroke, I don't, it sounds different to me.
It does.
I don't know if you can hear it.
Yep. Is the code.
Oh.
I think. Which I figured out by myself. Yay! flash behind him.
Let's see the seas. Oh yes, of course. Success. No! Okay. Hello?
Hello.
Come on, power of brain. No, okay. Okay. Okay, I'm just going to stop there. No, I pay.
What?
I was just thinking at the hardware store when we were arguing over who was paying for the key.
Oh, yes.
And I think I catched a glimpse of the cash with the cashier being like, oh my god.
Oh, wow. I know, we still totally act like we've been going out for like 2 weeks.
To replace it.
Oh no!
Look how many is left. She's okay?
Yeah, she's got a walker thing, but...
Are we allowed to talk about this? The camera?
Oh, yeah, not right now.
Thank you. keep thinking about how, like, once it's been a year that I've been playing, like, assuming I keep up the pace of how much I practice per day, or, like, at least practice once a day, or, you know, whatever. Practice more, or, like, practice less, but still be practicing. After a year, I keep thinking about, like, how much of this stuff will be, like firmly planted in my mind and my muscles, like the ability to play guitar, I mean. Like, it presumably it increases the longer you play, right?
Yeah, I assume so.
So I think, like, in a year I'll be so much better and things will come so much easier to me, at least in terms of, like, what I'm doing right now.
Yeah.
And then I think, like, in 5 years I'll be even more better. Then I think in 5 years I'll be 35. And then I think, well, 35's not that bad, I guess. And then 10 years I'll be 40. And I don't think I can... first of all, I don't think I can reasonably plan 5 years ahead.
True.
And second of all, I don't think I can reasonably plan 10 years ahead. But you know the idea of, like, 40-year-olds being 40-year-olds.
Yes, 40-year-olds are 40 years old. I've noticed that.
Did you say 40-year-olds are 40 years old?
40.
Yes. Yeah, but I don't know.
You totally did just say, like, you know, that thing about 40-year-olds being 40 years old.
No, I know, because I don't want to disparage them, because there's a lot of cool things about being 40, but...
Oh, I understand.
But, like, And when you're... I don't know, when I was, like, 16, I had no idea who Tom Waits was, I think. I don't think I knew about Tom Waits until I was, like, 21 or something. You know what I'm saying? So, like,
yeah.
As you get older, your idols get older.
Yeah.
But, and then I guess that's why, like, people who are, like, 65, like, start really getting into, like, God and stuff.
That's because God is, like, the oldest hero.
Or you know what I mean. Like, I don't know. I don't think my mom does that, but... I think I've heard my dad listening to some, like, gospel music or something.
Maybe he just likes the music.
I don't know. I don't know what's going on with my dad.
You should probably not.
I should probably what?
Not go into that.
No, I'm not insulting. This is outside of the spectrum of insulting him. I just mean, like, I don't know what... I don't know what occupies his life.
Hmm. Sure. Does anybody really know what you know?
My mom probably knows.
Oh, okay.
And his therapist probably knows.
Does he have a therapist? Like, he doesn't ever seem to go.
Yeah, he does. I don't know how often he goes. But I know he's, I've seen him go to appointments before, like, I think he's just, like, he never announces when he leaves, unless you're specifically in the room as he's, like, walking out the door.
Okay.
And obviously he's not going to go on the weekend. Keeping this journal that he keeps leaving out in, like, obvious places, like, please secretly read me.
Okay.
And I'm not reading it.
love of God, not another centaur.
You just don't like them because they're ugly.
I don't like them because they're terrifying. And they should not be.
So Mary Bell is still alive.
Yeah, I heard.
I assume she changed her name or something.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah.
She could be presumably married.
I think she has a kid.
How do we know that?
I think she gave an interview at some point that didn't disclose her name or where she lives.
I see. And is she like, I'm well adjusted aside from the fact that I'm married at all?
Yeah. I'm hoping that if she is married, she told her husband what she did when she was a kid. Oh, but by the way, I murdered somebody when I was a child.
Yeah. Who did you murder?
A little boy named Billy Gaffney.
The related searches in Google were like the Menendez brothers. And...
Well, yeah. So yeah, she didn't kill her parents, unlike the Menendez brothers.
She must almost definitely be on medication.
I don't know. I don't really understand how... I don't understand if that's something you can outgrow or what.
Murder?
Yeah, like being a... Like Kate. Like how Kate is a homicidal maniac. See?
Yeah.
Why didn't you murder him? I had to murder him. Never would have happened if you were murdered him.
I'm just saying, like, the police would talk to, I don't know. I think it would be arranged that she would be put on some kind of sedative. Like, not... I'm talking, like, completely outside of the realm of, like, clinical diagnosis and scientific study. I'm just talking about, like, what the police would want.
Yeah.
I'm slowly becoming oriented with what day of the week it is.
That's
good. When you go away and then come back next week, it'll be better.
Okay.
I told you how, like, you coming here every weekend, it's like, it separates the weeks for me.
Yeah.
It's a little confusing because he's been here for like 4 days, so...
Ah, so...
Ontario, and it is very good you are here for a full day.
You're
alive?
Yes.
I don't know where I am. Oh, there I am. Well, you know what they say.
What do they say?
Wherever you go, there's a man behind you with a knife.
No. I did not think they say that, small boy.
You're thinking of the you're confusing it with the original translation is wherever you go there you are. But
actually is there the man behind you with a knife?
It's wherever you go, comma, and the comma indicates you turning around and seeing there's a man holding a knife ready to stab you. So wherever you go, then your body turns around, there you are, and there's the man with a knife. Well, like you're saying there you are to the man with the knife, and then he stabs you repeatedly.
Okay.
You just kind of tune out the crazy after a while. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
I asked you if you tune out the crazy after a while.
I actually didn't hear you, sorry. Or like I was reading something, sorry. appears that yes, I do.
Yes, you do turn it to not the crazy.
This is awesome.
See, that's how they should deal with it at mental hospitals. So if someone's like running around screaming, jumping into walls, they just like all the nurses and psychiatrists should just like go into this like dreamlike state where they're unaware of what's happening around them. Can I say something crazy that you will not tune out? It's very great.
Okay.
I had this idea that, so you're taken to a mental hospital and they treat you for your mental illness, and then they say you can leave, but if you choose not to leave, you start doing low-level stuff like you'll start cleaning the beds and like putting fresh sheets on the beds, and then maybe one day they'll say, oh, do you want to help hand out the medication?
No.
And then
no.
You start handing out the medication.
No, it's not a good idea.
And then they're like, oh, do you want to help out, like, strapping this person to the bed? And then you help out strapping the person to the bed. Until they just give you an office and, like...
No.
You just sit there and read all the time.
No.
And if you ever leave the office, then you're a mental patient. But if you don't leave the office, you're a psychiatrist.
Okay.
So, you think that's how you become a psychiatrist?
Yes.
Creating some kind of satanic effect, so I'm going to stop doing that.
I hope you guys don't mind that before I risk my life for you, I'm going to go and take everything that you hold dear. It's okay.
Thank you. to stop with that.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm delaying a cigarette again.
I see.
Again. How dirty do they look?
They don't look dirty at all to me.
Wiping them really helped though.
Maybe you don't need glasses, maybe they're just dirty. Need new glasses, I mean.
Yeah, but I feel like I should be able to read the words on that screen on camera from the distance I'm at now.
I can.
You're closer, but...
Okay.
But, yeah, that's kind of what I mean. I mean, like, I don't have any major difficulties. In fact, I prefer the world blurred because of my anxiety. You know about that, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, anyways, I think I'm done for now. So, we are at 45 minutes.